வந்தே செம்புமாபதிம் சுரகுரும் வந்தே ஜெகத்காரணம் வந்தே பல்லகபூஷணம் சிசிதரம் வந்தே பசூனாம் பதிம் வந்தே சூரிய சசாங்க வன்னிநயனம் வந்தே முகுந்த பிரியம் வந்தே பக்தஜன ஆஸ்ரயம் ச வரதம் வந்தே பக்தஜன ஆஸ்ரயம் ச வரதம் வந்தே சிவம் சங்கரம். ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், யோகா இஸ் வைராக்ய. வை யோகா இம்ப்ளைஸ் வைராக்ய. தேர் கேனாட் பி எ யோகி ஹூ டஸ் நாட் ஹாவ் வைராக்ய. வாட் இஸ் திஸ் வைராக்ய? எ யோகி இஸ் நாட் ஃபேசினேட்டட் பை எனிதிங். A yogi is not enamored of anything. A yogi does not have any attraction anywhere. Nor does he hate anything. Neither likes nor dislikes. Neither raga nor dvesha. Neither attachment nor any indulgence. He is just withdrawn. There is no question of getting himself entangled in anything, nor does he avoid anything. Neither seek nor avoid is the policy of a yogi. He is not drawn head over the heels completely in something, and at the same time he does not shirk the duty. Such is the grandeur of a yogi. This vairagya comes to people on various occasions. Arjun arrives on the battlefield. He looks at his master, he looks at his grandfather, he looks at his friends, he looks at his cousins, and suddenly he feels, no, I shall not fight. There is vairagya. Fighting means killing. Why should I kill them? Poor people, their wives will be unhappy, their children will be unhappy. Why should I kill all these people? Let me not kill anyone and let me run away from the battlefield. Let us sit under the greenwood trees of shade. Let me close my nostrils. Let me meditate on Brahman and let me be a person of total vairagya sannyasa. And Krishna takes the whip. You useless fellow, you came to the battlefield and you have prepared so many people. Now at the time of actual fight, you want to run away. Shudram hrudaya daurbalyam. This is psychic weakness, man. You cannot be a sannyasi. If you run away and sit there, you think of Duryodhana. You think of Karna. You think of Draupadi, and yours is not total withdrawal. You have not yet developed vairagya. It is a temporary escapism. Similarly, when a man falls sick, what is the use of this world? What is the use of these doctors? What is the use of these medicines? Let me be peaceful. Let me meditate on Brahma. When the health is okay, he looks at a new girl. He searches for new food. All that Vedanta goes. If a person fails in the examination, if he is not selected in the interview, he takes Bhagavad Gita and he reads, I want to become a sannyasi. Failure makes a person run away. Sickness drives a person to become a sannyasi. And old people like me, we don't have anybody to love to. No girl will look at us. No love letter will come to us. And the body is weak, the body is old, and therefore we read Bhagavad Gita. Suppose some great man comes and makes my hair suddenly black, and the man of 76 years suddenly becomes a boy of 22 years. I throw the Bhagavad Gita out. I am once again bubbling with enthusiasm. Sickness, failure, old age, these are some of the factors which make a person sannyasi. Laziness also. A father has returned from some place. He has forgotten to buy betel leaves. He has the habit of using betel leaves and tobacco after food. He came at about 8:30 in the night and he does not have the betel leaves. Now he asks his son, who is about 15 years, "My dear son, go down. There is a shop. Please buy the betel leaves and bring it." Then the son is lazy. He says, "Daddy, if that shop is closed..." Then father says, "My boy, go just a few feet away. There is another shop, a bigger shop. There you will get betel leaves. Suppose that shop is also closed, today being holy, today being Sunday, suppose that is also closed, what shall I do?" "You go to the next street." "Daddy, by it's already 8:30 now. I see this shop closed, I see that shop closed. I go to the next street, it will be 9 o'clock. Suppose that is also closed. Just another few acts away, there is a bigger shop. It will not close, you go there. By the time I go there, it will be 10 o'clock. And today being an extraordinary holiday, suppose that shop is also closed." Then the father got fed up with the boy. "My son, if this shop is closed, that shop is closed, that shop is also closed, come back, don't worry." Then the son says, "Daddy, you are prepared to go to the bed without betel leaves? If this shop is closed, if that shop is closed, if the third shop is closed, if the fourth shop is closed, that means you are ready to go to the bed without betel leaves. Think they are not available and go to bed. What is after all? If you pass this examination, you have to make money. If you pass failure, then again you have to do all this imagination. Waste, let me sleep. What do I do on a holiday? Let me sleep." This is escapist. We don't want to do it. Laziness makes a man accept sannyas. 90% of the sannyasis are escapists. They don't want to take up responsibilities. Bhishma in the Mahabharata tells you sannyasis, you have a responsibility to the society. You are eating food from the society. Grihasthas are feeding you. Nature is feeding you. Society is feeding you. Should you not pay back the debt, you have a responsibility to the society. And also Adi Shankara has set an example. A sannyasi need not touch the feet of anybody, exception he must touch the feet of the mother. You are indebted. Shankara came all the way from north to do the last rites to his mother at Kaladi. Swami Vivekananda, though a sannyasi, discharged his duties to the mother, arranged a pilgrimage. He himself went with his mother, rather took his mother to Benares and performed the pilgrimage. Even a sannyasi cannot run away from the responsibilities of sannyasi. Then how to develop this vairagya, sir? Only one thing is permanent, sustainable sannyasa, workable sannyasa, and that is out of satiety, S-A-T-I-E-T-Y. In economics, we have the law of diminishing returns. That means when you eat the first gulab jam or the first rasgulla, when I describe that rasgulla, the white rasgulla, the soft rasgulla, the round rasgulla, the sweet rasgulla, the juicy rasgulla, the rasgullas floating in the liquid, soft sweetness, there is water here. You need not even see it if you make a mention. Beautiful girl, excellent complexion, lotus-like eyes, sampenga-like flower, ruby-like lips, pearl-like teeth. You need not look at the girl and there is a fascination. That rasgulla is brought and there is a meter. Suppose your yoga anusandhana samsthana develops a tool to measure the happiness that the man gets while eating rasgulla, the meter will go round, so much of happiness. First rasgulla. And second rasgulla, when you are eating, if it has gone 4 rounds, it goes only 3 rounds. Third rasgulla, 2 rounds. Fourth rasgulla, 1 round. Fifth rasgulla, 99. Sixth, 98. Seventh, 75. Eighth, 50. Suppose I take 48 rasgulla. 48 rasgulla when I am eating, the happiness is zero. And that lady asked, please sir, one more rasgulla sir. Somehow I close the nostrils, control my tongue and take the next rasgulla, and the meter shows minus happiness, reluctance, minus one. And that lady says, sir, for you I have prepared 128 rasgulla sir, there are so many sir, please take one more sir. I cannot. No sir, please sir. And then it comes to minus 20. 58 rasgullas I have eaten. And the 59th she brings. Ma, I am going to vomit no more. That vomiting sensation is vairagya. When you have the first rasgulla, it is made by the same cook. It is served by the same girl. It is eaten by the same person. The sweetness is same, the roundness is same, the softness is same. But the pleasure is extreme in the beginning. When you come to the 68th rasgulla, it reduces. And it comes to be minus. And when she brings the 78th rasgulla, I will run away from the house. Manu namaskar, I don't want it anymore. Because if I take, the whole thing will come out. That running away from rasgulla is called sannyas. When after say 68, entire life is like a rasgulla. Janma after janma, being born, growing up, preparing for the examination, getting the job, falling in love with a girl, marrying, begetting, striving, sickness, old age, dying, again being born, again growing, again marrying. All this life is like a huge rasgulla. Once, twice, three times, four times, punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi janani, jatare siyanam, iha samsare, kulut kaladustare. Again and again, to be born, to be educated, to be married, to be in love with the X or Y or Z, this is all a badarish. When it reaches the full brim of the experience, we feel like putting a stop to it. Otherwise we commit mistakes. When the tree is developing the fruit, before it is ripen, if you take the fruit, it gets the pain and there will be milk. When the tree is full, when the ripened fruit is there, the fruit falls automatically. Similarly, sannyasa or vairagya is automatic when it has grown to its full. A yogi is full of vairagya. Without vairagya, yoga is not possible. A yogi does not exist without Vairagya. Sri Ram, Sri Krishna, they are all wonderful yogis. They have Vairagya, neither seek nor avoid, but they discharge their duties perfectly well. Let us not run away. Let us not have a premature sannyasa. Only unripened, half boiled, half burned will commit the mistakes. Fully ripened fruit will not stick to the tree, it will fall automatically. A ripened sannyasi, a full grown yogi, will always be an asset to the society. By the grace of God Almighty, we have come to Prashanti. Let us develop that Vairagya and let us be the ripened fruits available for the society to be benefited by us. May we meditate on Lord Krishna, the Yogeshwara.
Shanti, Shanti.